Hi, everyone, and welcome to episode 3 of the MFG Hot Topic. Sam and I are here again, Sam Bainham from Connex Portal. And today we're going to be talking about an article that we both saw last week, as we usually do. This week, we're going to be talking about the article that was the results from 2020, the financial results for the economy. We saw a record slump of 9.99%. That is a record for the history books. However, we managed to avoid a double dip recession in that we grew by 1.2% in December. So that's fantastic news. I'll hand it over to Sam straight away. So Sam, from your point of view, how does this affect your businesses and in particular the members of Connex Portal?
Yeah, cheers, Ryan. Let's say it as it is. It's not great news. It's quite depressing in some instances. Let's not try and avoid that and try and just paper over what's going on. The issue with COVID, as everything's been going on, is that everything is so unknown. No one knows what's going to happen next week, let alone next year. And we can't guess what's going to happen this year. I mean, we can predict that hopefully everything's going in the right track and there is some positivity, but we still don't really know what's going to happen. And I do feel we are going to be feeling the effects of this for several years to come. Not necessarily the small companies may not see the effects to start with, as we were discussing this last week, that these large corporations might start to struggle, you know, later on this year, and then that will have a knock-on effect for the smaller companies that they're supplying into and the supply chain that is affected by that, something that may not be seen straight away. So that's something that businesses do have to be careful of and kind of plan in advance for that sort of thing, which actually goes back to our first video where we talked about reshoring and diversifying what you're offering, supporting clients that you may not usually deal with to try and minimize that risk. So if one of your larger companies does suffer the consequences of this, at least you've got your workload spread across various sectors. And that's exactly what we're trying to support through Connex. So learning about your supply chain, knowing your customers, collaborating with other companies, and sharing that knowledge to see if you can kind of improve those processes. Yes, as I said before, it's not great news. It wasn't a nice article to read. But you just have to look at some of the weekly manufacturing stories and the news articles coming out to notice that there are changes and there are positive impacts coming from this. It's not going to be a quick fix. It's not going to happen overnight, but I definitely think things are heading in the right direction, which is good. I probably speak to between 15 and 20 of our portal members a week, and I genuinely can't recall the last time one of them said that they weren't busy or had no new work coming through. So, you know, the UK manufacturing sector is ready to support this, and they are willing to work. To be honest, I don't see COVID or even Brexit stopping that. It's just about knowing who's local and knowing how you can boost your own kind of personal businesses. I really like the part of the article towards the end that was talking about the economy being like a coiled spring. So I don't know if there's any thoughts that you want to add on to that and to how that affects your customers and the guys that you're speaking to.
Yeah, thanks for that, Sam. So I think that was a really well-balanced argument. From my point of view, just to add, like you said, a little bit of a positive spin on it, Andy Haldane, who's the chief economist of the Bank of England, did say that the economy is like a coiled spring and that there is pent up financial energy. I think that is, for me, is a really powerful statement. And if we think about it, it is essentially going back to that coiled spring analogy. Businesses need to be thinking about that roadmap that Boris is going to set out on the 22nd of Feb. How is that going to affect their business? Are they going to have 3 weeks to go, you know, back to full capacity and the furlough scheme will be scrapped and people will start coming back? Or is it going to be more like 2 months? So I think for me, the most important thing is for my customers and people in general, SMEs in general, to look at their roadmap and how they're going to bring people back off furlough, how they're going to restart their business. They need to be planning 6 months in advance in terms of the workload that they've got on, everything like that. So really, for me, the advice is plan, but only do that when you know exactly what you can do when Boris does his roadmap. So that's my advice that I'm giving out to people. But have a plan, you know, have maybe a plan A for the next 3 months, but then really start to think about, after that roadmap's been set by Boris, exactly how you're going to restart. And I think if there is a lot of pent up energy, how are you going to focus on, you know, the more profitable deals that are kind of better for your operating profit, and how are you going to go after those kinds of deals? So how are you going to market yourself? How are you going to have strategic discussions and get yourself in the evoked set of people in the market to show that you're a thought leader, not just a part supplier? So that would be my view on it, Sam.
Yeah, no, I think that's a good way. I think agile and lean are going to start to be quite popular words again. I know they were before COVID, and it's, you know, being able to adapt and change. And I think that's just going to continue over the next few months and years as we start to hopefully see the back of this.
Absolutely. So I think, look, we'll wrap it up there for today. Again, you know, we've got the fourth in the series next week. The response we've had has been, you know, absolutely fantastic from everyone in the community. So feel free to carry on the conversation in the comment section. Give us a like, share, message, anything you like. But yeah, thank you so much for joining us this week. Thanks, Sam, for joining me. As always, you'll be presenting the next one. And that topic will be released next Wednesday or Thursday.
Brilliant.
Thanks
very much.